Hello, welcome viewers to Elimu TV, whereby we are going to learn and experience together. Today we are going to have our Biology Form 2, Lesson 8, whereby your tutor will be Mr. Gerard. We are going to handle the topic on transporting animals under the subtopic, the circulatory system.
Remember that in transport, in animals, there must be a circulatory system such that products are circulated all over the body. We're going to have the following lesson goal, whereby by the end of the lesson, you should be able to draw and label the structure of the open circulatory system in a cockroach. So, on the introduction of the circulatory system, we can say that large and complex animals have circulatory system that consists of tubes, a transport fluid and some means of pumping the fluid. A circulatory system transports substances within the body and maintains a steep concentration gradient at the surfaces where diffusion takes place. Such surfaces include we have the lungs, we have gills, and also we have the gut. There are two types of circulatory systems which exist in animals, whereby we have the open and the closed circulatory system, whereby we are going to discuss them in this lesson. Whereby in an open circulatory system, the transport fluid is not confined to the blood vessels, but is contained in the general body cavity, whereby the general body cavity is known as the animalcule. The transporting fluid in this open circulatory system is known as the hemolymph. And the open circulatory system is found in invertebrates, especially the arthropods. So that is something that you must know, that the open circulatory system is found in invertebrates. A closed circulatory system, on the other hand, is found in vertebrates and also the annelids, where the transport fluid is called blood. Which is conveyed in special tubes, referred to as blood vessels. So remember that we've said in invertebrates the transporting fluid is the hemocoel, while in invertebrates the transporting fluid is known as the blood. So now we are going to start with the open circulatory system, whereby we've said that it is mostly found in the insects. So we can give an example. So we can say insects are an example of animals that exhibit an open circulatory system. In insects, the transporting fluid, we have said, is the hemolymph, which it is contained in the hemocoel within a dorsal tubular arch. Another diagrammatic representation to show the same. These are a diagrammatic representation of a cockroach. So as I'm explaining, you can watch the diagram and we'll be together. The hemolymph contains suspended white. The hemolymph contains suspended white blood cells and some pigments, but is not largely involved in transport of oxygen and carbon dioxide. Transport of gases in insects is principally by dilution in the tubes called tracheals, as you can see the tubes or the tracheals from our diagram. In a typical insect, such as a cockroach, there is a tubular arch just above the alimentary canal. I guess we are able to notice the alimentary canal on our diagram. So just above it, we have the tubular arch. The arch has 13 chambers. It also comprises of 3 thoraxes and 10. We have 10 in the abdominal segments. Abdominal segments, they are confined just on the abdomen. So we have 10 of them. The anterior segment is joined to the outer that empties the hemolymph into sinuses in the head. You can see whereby we have the head, we have got sinuses, which is empty. You can see that the arrow on our diagram is representing the direction of flow of the hemocoel, which is the transporting fluid in this case. Each chamber has a pair of lateral openings, which are known as the ostia. The openings are generally known as the ostia, but singular, they are the ones that we are calling the ostium. Diagram, you can see the ostium on the abdomen, which are closed by valves. We also have the valves allow blood to flow into the arch through the ostia, but not out of it. That is a very important point, whereby we have said the valves allow blood to flow
the ostium. Remember, we have said that ostia is the plural form of ostium, because in our diagram we have only an ostium, because we are representing one ostium, but in plural they are being referred to as ostia. And you have said that the ostia do not allow blood to flow out of it. The anterior part of every chamber has a pair of valves that prevent backflow of the hemolymph. Remember, in higher organisms, where in the closed circulatory system, the backflow is being prevented by the valves. Also, in the case of the smaller organisms, those are the invertebrates, we have also valves which prevent the backflow of the hemolymph. Having done and said that, we can have the following activity, whereby you are required to give three characteristics of an open circulatory system. And remember, we have said an open circulatory system is generally found in invertebrates. For this lesson, the more of this lesson, you can get it on KLB, Secondary Biology Students Book 1, 4th edition, Nairobi, Kenya Literature Bureau. And for this lesson and more of biology lessons, you can send us an SMS through the number that is appearing on our screen, or you subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is Elimu TV, or you send us a message on our Facebook page, which is Elimu TV, or you send us a message on Twitter at Elimu TV _ Kenya. Let us subscribe to the channels that are on our screen, such that you can enjoy more of our biology lessons.